Hi there, folks, and welcome back. Right, okay, so it would appear that YouTube have got this glitch going again. The live stream I did last night, we had to cancel and restart it because of something that was going on with YouTube. I've just been informed by one of my subscribers, they've gone across to watch last night's live stream, and there seems to be a glitch in it. Now, I've logged into YouTube, I've gone to watch the video myself, and the video won't even load. So yeah, I don't know what's going on there with YouTube. So here I am having to make a video about something that we had a really good live stream about last night. And as you can see from the topic of today's video, it is in regards to a female, yeah, in a female club, who's been told basically by a fella that has got some interest in her and she's kind of likes him, that if they're to have a relationship, that she's got to leave her club. That his club has got a rule, yeah, that says that he cannot date anyone, yeah, from another motorcycle club. Okay, so yeah, so she contacted me about this and asked me if I'd ever heard of this before. Now, I have heard of this before. A couple of years ago, I was told about a situation like this and I couldn't actually believe it, because the situation a couple of years ago is very similar to this one. There was no reason within the club politics side of things for her, you know, to have to leave her club. The club's really good friends, get on great together. They're all part of the same, like, coalition of clubs and all this type of stuff, yeah? And I couldn't get my head around it then. Now, I can appreciate that, you know, when you have some clubs, especially a lot of the mixed gender clubs, seem to be waking up and having a realisation to this. And they're putting in place rules such as no inter-club relationships. Now, this girl's own club have got a rule that, because obviously, you know, people do bat for the same team as such. Now, her club has got this rule that you can't have a relationship with somebody within their own club, which, you know, I can understand that. As I say, I know a few clubs that have actually gone that way, that have brought in a new bylaw, that have introduced the bylaw, or even have the bylaw in there, and it's been in there since the start, that, you know, you can't have relationships within the club. Now, I totally understand that. But the fact is that this girl who's contacted me, or this woman, should I say, that's contacted me, she was in a mixed gender club, and a few of her friends and herself and one of her family members, a cousin, they went off and they founded an all-female club. And as I say, the only rule they have in their club about dating people is that you can't date within the club, okay? It doesn't say anything about dating outside the club. But this guy is in a club, and his club rules, bylaws, say that members of that club, they can't date anybody at all that's in another club. Absolutely not. And she kind of likes him, but she's kind of oohing and haahing about it. But he keeps putting pressure on her to leave her own club so they can have a relationship. Now, the thing of it is, if she leaves her club, they've got a bylaw in their club, yeah, that says she can never go back to the club, that she's out permanent. She basically becomes a no-mark, like being put out in bad standing type thing, that none of the girls would go to her engagement if the relationship developed, or to her wedding or anything. She'd be outcast, and there's a no return. Now, I said to her, I said, look, I can't advise you on a personal relationship, speaking like one-on-one as we are, but, you know, when I make a video like this, I can air my opinion. Now, to be quite honest with you, I think this sort of stuff is really archaic. Now, if there was a situation where you've got two big dominant clubs in an area and they're at odds with each other, yeah, and her club is friends, really good friends with, you know, an opposing club, you know, and this guy is in, you know, one of the other clubs that's opposed to that club, you know, and he wants to have a relationship with her and what have you, I can understand that, but they're not. There is none of that situation in the area where they live. Both of the clubs are all part of the same group of clubs that go up to a, you know, a coalition thing together. So there's no reason with club politics for this to be in place. But he's insisting that she leaves her club so that they can have a relationship. Now, personally, and also the other thing of it is, he's a patch holder within his club. He doesn't hold an officer's position or nothing, but in her club, she holds an officer's position. She's a founding member, you know, and he's saying to her, if you want to be in a relationship, you've got to leave your club. Now, personally, if it was me, I wouldn't be having a bar of it in her position. Absolutely wouldn't be having a bar of it. I'd say, no, I'd rather not be in a relationship. If I've got to make all these big, big sacrifices and you're not going to sacrifice anything yourself, well, then no, I don't want to be a bar of it. Because at the end of the day, what I'm gathering is that she's got to make all the sacrifices and he stays, remains in his club. But she's got to give up everything. And to me, I don't think that's right. I don't think that's right at all, because there's no reason in the politics of the area where she is, you know, from the conversation that I've had with her, that she should have to do this. I mean, it's just ridiculous. I mean, it's beyond a joke. You know, I can understand the fact that, you know, they're part of the same alliance or whatever. I can get all the gist of that. But you see, the thing of it is, he's making her to be in a relationship, basically. She's the one that's got to make all the sacrifices, and he's not willing to make any sacrifices. So at the end of the day, as far as I'm concerned, that's a one-way street. It's not a two-way street, is it? And the fact is that, you know, she leaves her club, they've got a no-go back bylaw in their club. She can't go back to the club. You know, she'll basically be put out like she was in bad standing if she leaves, because none of the club are going to stay in touch with her or anything like that. It puts a member of her own family in a predicament too, because her cousin's in the club. So this is just, you know, it's absolutely outrageous, to be quite honest with you. I think it's kind of like archaic, you know. And the fact is that he doesn't want to make any sacrifices, but she's the one that's got to make all the sacrifices. Just makes this even more outrageous. You know, at the end of the day, relationships are supposed to be a two-way street, you know, not one person making all the sacrifices and the other person carrying on as normal. But this is my thoughts on this, and I, to be quite honest with you, I think it's archaic the way it's being done, this situation. There is no reason for her to have to leave her club. It just is just outrageous. It's, you know, I can, like I say, I can understand if there was a, you know, club politics issue involved here, but there isn't. And she's the one that's having to make all the sacrifices. So if you're watching this one, this video, I don't know if you were watching the live stream. You didn't get me on Messenger or anything last night, so I'm guessing you didn't watch the live stream. But if you see this, yeah, this is my thoughts on it, you know. It sounds to me like it's all one-way traffic, that you're the one that's having to make all the sacrifices. I can't understand why this rule is in place for an area where you live in, where there's no issues with politics, you know, and that's just my thoughts on it. Anyway, I'd be interested in other people's opinions on this. Yeah, leave your comments down in the comments. Yeah, I'll catch you all another day, another way. As you can hear, this live stream, this video is being interrupted as well. It's like this video is doomed. You know, we've got people digging the road up now. So I'm going to cut you loose, and I'll catch you another day, another way. Bye now.